So for today, we will talk about the shortcut that we can use to find the derivative of a common function without having to go through the derivative definition like we do last time. So let me just do these one by one. The first rule, the constant rule, this guy says the derivative of a constant function is going to be zero. The single variable rule says the derivative of the single variable x is going to be 1. The power rule said the derivative of x to the n is going to be n times x to the n minus 1. So usually when you think of the power rule, you can think of it this way. If you have x to the n as your function, then the derivative of this guy is going to be that you bring the exponent down, so that exponent n becomes the multiplier to your function. And because n already come down, you actually have to reduce the power by 1, so it's going to be n times x to the n minus 1. So that's the power rule. So this is going to be a rule that we're going to use quite a lot. The constant multiplier rule basically said that if you have a constant multiplied to a function, what you can do is you can kind of ignore that constant. So if you don't do anything with the constant, what you can do is you can just take the derivative of a function. The sum and difference rule said if you have two functions f and g being added or subtracted, then when you take the derivative of f plus g or f minus g, you can just take the derivative of each function individually and then add or subtract them afterwards. So this rule should be enough for us to do some of the examples down here. So let me go over these examples real quick. The first function, I have 5 times x cubed. So 5 is a constant, and x cubed, this is my power function. So when I want to take the derivative, my derivative is going to be that my, because of the constant multiple rule, whenever I have a constant being multiplied to my function, I don't have to do anything with it, it just stays here. So my 5 stay there. That's nothing I need to do. Now, I take the derivative of the x cubed. The x cubed is a power function. So the derivative of x to the n, in this case, is going to be n times x to the n minus 1. So, what I do is, I bring the, I multiply 5 by the derivative of x cubed. The derivative of x cubed is going to be that the 3 comes down, and then I reduce the power by 1. So it's going to be 3 times x squared. And well, you can kind of combine that together and make that 15x squared. So that's pretty straightforward. The second function, my f of x, is x cubed plus 5. So the difference between a and b is that in part a, my constant is multiplied to my function. In my part b, my constant is being added to my function. So we actually need two different ways to deal with this case. F prime of x in this case is going to be, well, the derivative, I'm going to have to use the sum or difference rule here. So I take the derivative for these guys individually and then just add them back together. The derivative of x cubed, we did that already, that's going to be 3x squared plus, what is the derivative of 5? Well, now 5 is by itself, 5 is not multiplied to any function, so this falls into the constant rule. The derivative of a constant function is just going to be 0. So the derivative of 5 in this case is going to be 0, and that's going to be 3x squared. So notice how 5 is treated differently in part A and B, and that's because of in part A, if being multiplied in part B, it's being added. So let me do more example here. In part C, I have 3x to the 5th plus x plus 2. Well, this is nothing to be afraid of. If I have three terms in added, I just have to take the derivative of each of the terms individually, and then add them back when I'm done. The derivative of 3x to the fifth is going to be, well, 3 is a constant, so it stay there. The derivative of x to the fifth is going to be 5 times x to the fourth. So again, I bring the 5 down and reduce the power by 1, so 5 comes down there. And the exponent is reduced from 5 to 4. What is the derivative of x? The derivative of x is going to be, well, you can think of this as a single variable rule. The derivative of x is going to be just 1. The other way you can think of the derivative of x is that if your f of x is just x itself, well, x itself is x to the 1. So the derivative of that, it's going to be, you bring 1 down, so it's going to be 1 times x to the 1 minus 1, so that's 0. But x to the 0 is 1, so that whole thing becomes 1. So you can actually derive the single variable rule from the power rule. But in any case, the derivative of x is going to be 1. The derivative of 2, 2 is a constant, and it's not multiplied to anything, so the derivative of that is going to be 0. So that whole thing becomes 15x to the 4th plus 1. So that's the answer for my part C. Mm-hmm.